couldn't even tell her parents what she was doing, arranging funds, teaching kids, empowering women and children of the slums. She has come a long way. Touching Lives Today provides microfinance opportunities, education, healthcare, and nurtures special talent amongst children and women. It has been a struggle for her in many ways because she chose to do challenging over tougher jobs. Today, Touching Lives operate from a structured building that she has bought and managed to turn her services into a full-fledged organization. She has taken over stage. She has taken over GAs who supports her endeavors and provides volunteers. Her work is not only with the slum children, but also with women who are offered vocational training, computer classes, life skills, personality development program, besides others. She also works with another NGO called Atmaviswas, where she is a trustee and works with people with special needs in the age group of 18 to 65. She has an interesting background in clinical psychology and clinical hypnotherapy. She funds her NGO, buys her books with Magna Publication, and published tales from Indian mythology, Mahabharata and Ramayana for children selected at Frankfurt Book Fair in 2006. She has also received the Aga Khan Youth Award for Excellency in Leadership in 2007. Holistic in approach, she wishes to serve humanity through every breath she lives. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and welcome the philanthropist herself.
I lived at the third floor and I was kneeling down and I was sitting. going down. And in no split of second, I found myself down. And I'm looking up, and I'm wondering what just happened. I don't know what happened to me. What will my mom tell me? How did I come here? What I'm going to tell her? And while walking up that staircase, I was wondering, my hand doesn't reach the bell. How am I going to open the door? As I reached on the third story, I saw that my door was half open. I sneaked inside. I saw my mother right in front of me, but she did not see me. I mean, I was not present to her at all. I went behind her and looked at the balcony, and I saw my body there. And some ray of light, some cord of light, just connected this self with that body, and zoom, there was something that happened. That was one of the things that I had stored inside. Probably that time I didn't know what my all this experience was. Today, of course, we know that this is what was the outcome of this experience. And in this box that I saw, this first secret that I had stored, I realized my entire life is based on the learnings of these secrets. My entire life, whatever I do, everything operates from this inner box that is filled inside me. Well, there are five things that I learned which I would like to share from this particular first truth. I understood that there was more beyond this physical body, there was more beyond this physical reality that we are in right now, which is called as the metaphysical world, which is invisible, but yet present. So for example, if I press the button, then the fan starts. Electric wires are required. Is that enough? We need electric current. But can you see the current? You cannot see it. I realize that there is this physical reality and there is this world called as the metaphysical world, which is invisible yet present. I understood that these two worlds are connected with each other. If I have a bad nightmare in the night, I will wake up, my body is going to shiver, I'm going to sweat. This is happening in the physical reality. But if I ask, where did the dream come from? The dream came in your mind. And so whatever happens in the invisible world is connected with the visible world. And whatever happens in the visible world is somewhere connected with the metaphysical world. As I'm communicating right now in terms of language, in terms of speech, communication in the invisible world happens through feelings, through imagination, and through intuition, which we all have. We don't fool ourselves. And we learn how to imagine. Imagination is what we are born with. Intuition is what we are born with. If I right now ask you, imagine your mother, you will have a picture of her. Imagine a snake, you have a picture of it. Nobody teaches us to imagine. And I understood that. Imagination feelings and intuition are the communication, are the tools of communication to the invisible world. Another interesting thing that I learned was this universal connect. Imagine yourself that you are here right now in the center. You are definitely connected with your family. The family is connected to a community, to the invisible world as well. And thus, the journey of touching life started in 2003 with the basic belief that it is my need to serve and go and say that I will go and serve the needy. I understood that in the physical world, seva can be done through actions. And in the invisible world, the seva, the service, can be done through healing, therapies, and through meditation. And in touching lives, in our organization, we give children an opportunity to experience this natural powers. Imagination, intuition, feelings. All that we do is help the child get connected with this little box of truth inside it and live that truth completely. Over past 10 years, we formed this five basic foundational values that we just don't apply in the work that we do, but all of us live this values in our day-to-day lives. The first value is, we realize that it is completely our need to serve than saying that we are willing to serve and doing it. Because I like doing what I like doing, I'm doing it. The second is, we don't label anybody as underprivileged or destitute or ill. The very fact that we are all born on this planet Earth together is the fact that we are all privileged. The third thing is, no one is something. Which means that whatever happens in life, good or bad, am I in the position to accept whatever has happened and not invest my energy in stopping that, but can I create a parallel path where the person or the people or myself have an opportunity to make a choice whether I want to go here. What is the sharing? And there is this concept of petit. Is whatever you have, how little you have, a certain percentage you share. How interesting it would be to share your prayers in your mind and in your heart. And how much time does it take? And now we already know that meditation and prayers do make an impact in the physical reality because both are connected to each other. So in touching lives, we share our resources, we share our wisdom, we share our lives with people. The fifth is the evolution. Every day we do ask ourselves one simple question. What am I doing? Is that really evolving my soul? Whatever I'm doing in my life right now, each and every day, how am I evolving as a person? How am I understanding my own soul and engaging it? So our group of touching lives, we make it a point that we work on ourselves, we heal ourselves, we empty ourselves, we go into the zone of nothingness, because when you're empty, giving just happens effortlessly. Touching life is about action as well as motivation. Now, a few interesting stories of our kids, and I thought to bring those stories to you to understand that how they have started impacting their lives. These are the kids who live in the slums. Ram is a boy who is now 17-year-old, started coming to us around 6 years ago. And every day, 4 o'clock in the morning, he wakes up and he goes to help his father to arrange market because his father is a hawker. And then after that, he comes back, he goes to college, he comes back, comes to touching lives, and then he goes back to work. And he has a story to say.
बातें करती थी तो उस बंदे को बता कि ये बातें और उसकी जो प्रॉब्लम है सच में उसमें सॉल्व हो जाती है। और मुझे अब मेरे मैं इसलिए मतलब मेरी क्लिनिक पावर बहुत एकदम पावरफुल है, मैं जो बोलता हूँ सच में होता है, इसलिए मैं सोचा कि मैं साइकोलॉजिस्ट बनूंगा। मैं उस काम पे निकल चुका हूँ।
Thank you.